With me here in the studio this afternoon, I'm joined by Dr. Navid Malik from the Life Sciences Division. Good to see you. Thanks very much for
coming.
Thanks,
Andrew.
If you could just remind me, you and I have spoken in the past, but yes. The Life Sciences Division, what's the connection here with ImmuPharma?
Yes, so Life Sciences Division, I'm an executive director of the bank, is a fully regulated FCA investment bank. We have a number of clients in the healthcare space. We act as financial advisor or broker to those companies. And with ImmuPharma, we have a financial advisory role for the company. We also produce equity research covering the company as a stock as well.
And the purpose of our previous chat was back in May, I believe, you had that detailed initiation note. You've since had a new research note issued. Just tell me a bit more about the reason behind the new note and what's in it.
Yes, so the initiation note was really about setting the scene for the company and particularly for Lupuzor. The note was written a period of time after the readout last year of the phase 3 clinical trial. We felt, as I said previously, that there was an opportunity to explain the data behind the trial and show how we felt Lupuzor had real potential in lupus as a new drug. The new note has been triggered because there was an update in the market from a pharmaceutical company called AstraZeneca. It's one of the biggest companies in the world, very successful in the antibody space. And they had announced the results of a study called TULIP-2. TULIP-2 was a study in lupus on a drug called Anifrolumab. This drug had an interesting history because a year ago, a study called TULIP-1 actually failed its primary endpoint in the phase 3 trial. But to the surprise of everybody, including ourselves, the TULIP-2 study, which was done at a couple of doses in a similar patient population but with a different endpoint, that study was successful. So that caused us some surprise, and we realized that that's actually a real benefit we feel to the lupus field in terms of what the industry is doing to drive new drugs to market, and particularly positive for AstraZeneca because of that.
So do you feel to some degree refocusing investors' minds, not just on lupus, but ImmuPharma Lupuzor?
Exactly, because what's important is following the AstraZeneca update, our investment thesis in Lupuzor and ImmuPharma is actually intact. In fact, it's strengthened because I wanted to draw a comparison with the immune therapy field, the checkpoint inhibitors and these antibodies in cancer that have revolutionized various cancers in the last 4 or 5 years. Merck and Bristol Myers Squibb have been driving that charge. But basically, that whole field was dying because a number of pre-existing technologies and approaches had failed. And then it took a drug called Yervoy in melanoma about 4 or 5 years ago to show that the whole immune therapy field basically had swayed to a different level. The target was correct, but they needed more time to figure out whether the drug worked. And post that period, we now have a $100 billion plus market that's come from pretty much nowhere. The lupus space is, in my mind, following a similar track. A lot of disappointment clinically with various clinical trials. Some pharma companies have abandoned development in the space. But we're now seeing the first etchings of success. This phase 3 trial with AstraZeneca, the TULIP-2 study, and the fact that AstraZeneca had that subgroup within the original study, you know, the European cohort that showed a statistical significance in the first study that they announced last year, shows us very strongly that the mirroring example of what happened with immune therapies in cancer is happening right now with lupus. And that's a very strong validation signal for us that we're going to see more success in the field. And our belief is that lupus is always going to drive some of that success.
So without putting words in your mouth, you feel we could be, if you like, at a turning point in bringing lupus drugs to market?
In fact, I'd say an inflection point. I'd say that we're now starting to better understand the disease, but what's a very important marker for me as an analyst covering ImmuPharma is that we have a tangible, fact-based story here. We have a biomarker which we know works exceptionally well in patients when they're given the drug. In other words, the patients who have the more severe disease with this, what they call the auto-dsDNA antibody, respond exquisitely well to Lupuzor. The patients who don't have that antibody don't respond well. They respond like a placebo. So in other words, we have a way to go forward in a second study in this group, which is about 70% of lupus patients, so it's not a small group, in a similar way to what AstraZeneca's done with as they're carving out their market with their drug, which was successful in TULIP-2 study.
I know you've set a target price of 76p here for ImmuPharma.
Yes.
What needs to be done between now and then in order to achieve that?
So we believe that ImmuPharma is strongly positioned to start looking at doing a second phase 3, either through a partnered approach with a pharmaceutical company, for example, or through other mechanisms to fund that trial. The cards are now stacked in favor of ImmuPharma in our view. So we believe that starting, getting a licensing deal potentially, or a mechanism to fund that trial, will be the start of the inflection point as the story builds. But as we identified in our initiation note in May, ImmuPharma has a number of other assets that are going to build value as well over time. Lupuzor is the main driver, the most important value driver in the business, but there are other technologies in the business that are going to be equally successful, we feel. So that 76 pence price target on the time value of money as they deliver further inflection points and data in the next study that they conduct will drive towards that price target, I think, quite comfortably.
Navid, always good to see you. Thanks for your
time. Thank you so much, Andrew.